Now, a question that we sometimes get is it bad to drink your calories? So, what people are asking is, should you avoid things like orange juice or apple juice, any type of liquid that has calories in it? Now, 5 or 10 years ago, it wasn't as easy to track your food as it is today. Now we have smartphones and apps like MyFitnessPal that make it very easy to find out exactly how many calories we're consuming. But 10 years ago, we didn't have this technology that made it easy for us to track our food. So one way that we could easily cut calories out of our diet to try to put ourselves into a calorie deficit to try to lose fat would be by eliminating liquids that are high in calories. And the reason we'd want to start with liquids is because they digest really fast. So anytime you feel hunger, that just means your stomach is empty and there's room for more food. Because liquids digest quickly, you're taking in a lot of calories, but it's not filling you up for a long time, so you're going to be hungry again soon after. But there's nothing inherently bad about the calories that come from a liquid, as long as you're limiting your total calorie intake, assuming your goal is to either maintain or lose weight. Now, the argument that some clean eating gurus like to say is that the amount of sugar or carbs in a drink like orange juice, for example, is many times the amount of what you would get from a single orange. And that's true. It takes about 2 to 4 whole oranges to make a glass of orange juice. But what I think's interesting about this is these same people often tout something like coconut oil as a superfood. Now, if you squeeze a coconut, is coconut oil going to come out? No, it's not. In fact, it takes over 20 coconuts to make a liter of coconut oil. This big jar right here isn't even 1 whole liter. You'd have to have over 20 coconuts to get what's in this jar. Compare that to 2 to 4 oranges, it's not even a contest. Now you might be thinking, Tony, we're not gonna drink this whole jar of coconut oil at once. And that is true. But these people that promote clean eating are always promoting not eating any processed foods. They act as if the calories from processed foods are somehow special and those go directly to your body fat, where calories from unprocessed foods don't. Now here's a question for you. What takes more processing? Squeezing an orange and getting juice out of it, or the 7-step process to get oil out of a coconut, which involves cutting the coconut, pulling out the flesh of the coconut, separating it, cooking it, letting it sit. It takes over a day to make coconut oil, where you can have juice from an orange in a matter of seconds. The whole point of this video is you can have calories from any source that you want and still lose body fat and lose weight if you are in a calorie deficit. Now, there's a ton of reasons why you might want to choose whole foods over liquids or unprocessed foods over processed foods, but none of those have anything to do with the actual calories and where they come from as far as how they react in your body. The calories from coconut oil are going to react the same way as calories from orange juice versus any other foods. If you're overeating those foods, you're gonna gain weight. If you're in a calorie deficit, you're gonna lose weight. If you like to enjoy a glass of orange juice in the morning and you can do that every day without drinking too much and going over your total calories, drink away.